Now, welcome to new sessions of our learning process, and we are in chapter number 2. Okay, so exercise 2.2, question number 2, find a quadratic polynomial each with the given numbers as the sum and product of its zeros respectively. So the first number given here is the product of two zeros for a quadratic polynomial, and the second minus one given is, sorry, the first one is the sum of zeros of any quadratic polynomial, and minus one is the product of the same quadratic polynomial, and we have to find this quadratic polynomial. Okay, now we know the relationship between zeros and coefficients. So this one is the polynomial x square plus bx plus c. Okay, and alpha and beta are its zero. So we have learned there exists two relations between zeros of the polynomial and coefficients of the polynomial. Sum of zero is equal to minus b upon a, means minus coefficient of x, b is the coefficient of x and a is the coefficient of x square, and the sign, negative sign will be there. Okay, so and the second relation is product of zeros can directly be found out using the coefficient. How it is? Product of zeros is equal to c upon a, where c stands for constant term and a stands for coefficient of x square. So if you divide the constant term by the coefficient of x square, then you directly find out product of two zeros. But here we have to go through the reverse process. The given numbers are sum of zeros and product of zeros, and we have to find out that particular quadratic polynomial whose sum of zeros is 1/4 and the product of zeros is minus 1. Okay, my friend. Now we know that alpha plus beta is equal to 1/4, because the given number is a sum of zeros for a quadratic polynomial. Now alpha plus beta, with the formula of alpha plus beta is minus b upon a is equal to 1/4. Okay, minus b upon a is equal to 1/4. It's given here. Now the other thing given here is alpha into beta. Product of two zeros are given. It's a minus 1. Now alpha into beta is c upon a. It will be minus a upon minus 1 upon 1, because we need the number in numerator and denominator form. Now compare these two numbers. Here a is denominator, here also a is denominator. But my friend, so the digit against a is 4 here, and the digit against a is 1 here. So in both the places, in both the cases, a number against a must be same. Here is 4, here is 1. So we will multiply this number by 4 upon 4 to get 4 as a denominator. It's a 4 ones are minus 4 and 4 ones are 4. Because we want the same number for a, here is 4, here it was 1, so multiplied by 4. So you also have to multiply the numerator by the same number. Okay. Now minus b upon a is equal to 1 upon 4, and c upon a is equal to minus 4 upon 4. So it's obvious that a is equal to 4. A is equal to 4. Now minus b is equal to 1. So b will be minus 1, and c is equal to minus 4. So the required, the polynomial is p of x is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. So it's a general practice to put a coefficient k 2 as a multiplication of the polynomial. Okay. So k, what is a here? A is 4 x square plus b is minus 1 into x plus c is minus 4. So the answer is k into 4x square minus x minus 4. And this is the polynomial 4x square minus x minus 4. Why k is multiplied? See, if it is 8x square minus 2x minus 8, if this one is the polynomial, you will get the same zeros as this polynomial have, and you will get sum of zeros and product of zeros respectively 1 by 4 and minus 1. So if any polynomial is multiplied by any number, then its zeros will not be changed. Okay, the polynomial 4x square minus x minus 4, zeros of this polynomial and zeros of this polynomial will be the same. So that is why there is a practice to put k before the shortest form of the polynomial. Okay, I think you have got this. Okay, now let us go for one more. It is number 2. See, sum of 0 is equal to root 2 and product of 0 is equal to 1 by 3. Okay. Now, sum of zeros is equal to root 2. As we know that sum of zeros, the formula to find the sum of zeros is minus b upon a is equal to root 2 upon 1. Because if it is numerator denominator form, here it should be a numerator denominator form. Is nothing there as a denominator, you can write 1. Okay, keep it as it is. Now think of this. Alpha into beta is 1 by 3. So C upon A is equal to 1 by 3. Now compare A here. The digit against A is 1 here and the digit against A is 3 here. So what should be done? This number should be multiplied by 3 upon 3 to get the same denominator for the side. So minus b upon a will be 3 root 2 divided by 3. Now you can see that in both the places the digit against a is same. Okay. Now we have to write the coefficients. A is equal to 3, minus b is equal to minus, you can directly write, if minus b is equal to 3 root 2, then b is equal to minus 3 root 2. And C is equal to 1. So the polynomial is P of x is equal to k ax square plus bx plus c. Okay. So is equal to k into a. What is a here? 3 x square plus b, it's a minus 3 root 2, minus 3 root 2 into x plus c is 1 here. So the answer is k into 3x square minus 3 root 2 x plus 1. Okay, very easy. So you can, there can be a 1 mark question for this type, you can get 1 mark for this type of question only. Okay, now we will see one more. Okay, may it be the third one, may it be the fourth one. Yes, third one. Alpha plus beta is equal to 0 and alpha into beta is equal to
root 5.
Now let us start. So alpha plus beta stands for minus b upon a. So minus b upon a is the formula to find alpha plus beta. It's 0, 0 divided by 1. Here alpha into beta is c upon a is equal to root 5 upon 1. You can see the same number against both the side against a. So a is equal to 1. Minus b is equal to 0, b is also equal to 0, so because negative of 0 is also 0, and c is equal to root 5. So the required polynomial p of x is equal to k into x square plus bx plus c here. It's a k, a is 1, means 1x square, plus b is 0, it's a 0x, plus c is root 5. So k here, it's x square, 0 multiplied by x will be 0 and will be cancelled, plus root 5. Okay. So this is the required polynomial. Okay, very good. Now division algorithm for polynomials, the next topics. See, three more questions are there and it is given to you to be completed in homework. Okay, so the next question is, next point is of division algorithm, means division of polynomial by polynomial. And the topic is division algorithm. Division algorithm means division of a polynomial by a polynomial. Okay, so we'll start with example 6. It's divide 2x square plus 3x plus 1 by x plus 2. Now this is the long division process. There can be synthetic division also, but here we will divide using a long division. Okay. So be sure whether the given polynomial is in a standard form or not. We are familiar with the division of numbers. Okay, we are familiar with the division of numbers. So if you divide any polynomial by a lower degree polynomial, so higher degree polynomial only can be divided by lower degree polynomial. So this one is a dividend. This one is a dividend polynomial. This one is a divisor polynomial. So we get two more polynomials as a quotient polynomial and remainder polynomial. Okay, let us start. 2x square plus 3x plus 1 divided by x plus 2. We have learned this process of division in standard 9. Now how to, if we forgot this the process, then we will revise here. Okay, now think, what term should be multiplied to x to get 2x square. What should be multiplied to x to get the product 2x square? Okay, so think separately of coefficients and variables. Here is 1 as a coefficient. So 1 is multiplied to 2 to get 2 as a product. So 1, 2 is 2. Now think of variables. 1 degree variable here is x raised to 1 here. So, and we want x square. So, we have to multiply. X is multiplied by x so that we get x square as a product. So, x into 2x will be 2x square. X into 2x will be 2x square. And then, the second term of the divisor polynomial should also be multiplied by the first term of quotient. 2 into 2x will be 4x. Okay, now both the terms of divisor polynomial is multiplied by this. Now we have to change the sign of this. Here it is positive sign, we will give it negative sign. Here also positive, we will get it negative. So we have to change the signs. As you know that first term will be cancel. Okay, now 3x minus 4x will be minus x. Now drop down this term. So it's minus x plus 1. So now once again think. X multiply x with a number or with a term so that we get minus x. So which term should be multiplied to x to get a minus x as a product? It is none other than minus 1. X into minus 1 is equal to minus x, minus a. So x into minus 1 will be minus x, and 2 into minus 1 will be minus 2. So now we have to change the signs of both these terms. It will be plus, it will also be plus. Cancel, so plus 1 plus 2 will be 3, plus 3. Then quotient polynomial is equal to 2x minus 1, and the remainder polynomial is equal to 3. It can also be written like this: 2x square plus 3x plus 1. Dividend is equal to divisor multiplied by quotient. X plus 2 into 2x minus 1 plus remainder. So P of x is a dividend is equal to S of x into Q of x. Rather, it is known as g of x. The divisor polynomial is symbolically written as g of x into q of x. Quotient polynomial is written as symbolically q of x. And the remainder polynomial is written as r of x. So, divisor polynomial is equal to dividend polynomial, is equal to divisor polynomial into quotient polynomial plus remainder polynomial. See, this is known as division algorithm. Okay, you can check it also. Usko aap check bhi kar sakte ho. Ye divisor aur quotient ko multiply karke usme remainder ko add karo to aapko divided polynomial mil jayegi. Usko verification of the division algorithm bolte hain. वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ डिवीजन एल्गोरिदम बोलते हैं. उसको वेरीफाई भी कर सकते हैं. राइट हैंड साइड के जो प्रोसेस है उसको पूरा करो तो आपको लेफ्ट हैंड साइड का वैल्यू मिल जाएगी. उसको वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ डिवीजन एल्गोरिदम प्रोसेस भी बोलते हैं. ओके, नाउ go for the exercise 2.3. Okay, we'll go for the exercise 2.3. Question number 1. Okay, divide px by gx. Okay, px is the dividend polynomial and g of x is the remainder polynomial. So first one is p of x is equal to x cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3, and g of x is equal to x square minus 2. Now using long division we will divide it. See, x square x cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3. Be sure the given polynomial is in a standard form, means if it starts from the cube 3 power of x, then there must be a 2 power of x, there must be a term with 1 power, there must be a constant term. X raised to 3, x raised to 2, x raised to 1 and constant term. It should be in the decreasing order of the power of variable or increasing order. Here look at it, x square minus 2, there is no term here with 1 power of x. So it is better to write x square plus 0x minus 2. Okay, to avoid mistake, it is a good practice to put any missing number with 0 as a coefficient to it. Okay, now x square multiplied by which term so that we get x cube? X square multiplied by which term so that we get x cube as a product? It is x. So x square into x will be x cube. Then the remaining two terms also multiplied by x. So 0x into x will be 0x square, and minus 2 into x is minus 2x. Here minus, minus and plus, we have to change the sign. Cancel, x cube plus minus x cube cancel. Minus 3x square minus 0x square, that is minus 3x square. And plus 5x plus 2x is plus 7x. Now drop down minus 3 here. Again think, x square to be multiplied to which term to get minus 3x square as a product? X square into what will be minus 3x square? It is minus 3. Okay, 1 into minus 3 will be minus 3, x square is as it is. So x square into minus 3 is minus 3x square plus minus minus 0x into 3, that is 0x, and minus minus plus 2, 3 is 6. Now again change the sign, plus plus and minus. Okay, so 7x, that is 7x, minus 9 minus 6, that is minus 9. Okay, now see, the degree of remainder is less than degree of the divisor. Okay, it is always there. Now we can write that x cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3, dividend is equal to divisor, x square minus 2 into quotient, x minus 3 plus remainder 7x minus 9. This is the remainder polynomial. Okay, or you can write the quotient polynomial is equal to x minus 3 and the remainder polynomial is 7x minus 9. Okay, getting it? Go for some more. Yes, of course, yes. Second one, yes, P of x is equal to x raised to 4 minus 3x square plus 4x plus 5 and g of x is equal to x square plus 1 minus x. Okay, my friend. If the given polynomial is not in a standard form, then convert it. Okay. So we have to write here x raised to 4 plus no term with x cube. So we write 0x cube minus 3x square plus 4x plus 5. And it is better to write x square minus x plus 1. Change the order to bring it into standard form. Now x raised to 4 plus 0x cube minus 3x square plus 4x plus 5, it's x square minus x plus 1. Okay, let us start our thinking process. Starts now. X square multiplied by this to get x raised to 4. X square by multiplied by x square, so that we get x raised to 4 as a product. X square here, x square into x square will be x raised to 4, minus x into x square will be minus x cube, 1x cube, and plus 1 into x square will be x square. So minus plus minus cancelled. 0x cube plus x cube is x cube, minus 3x square minus x square is minus 4x square. Now it's a 4x. Now think, x square is multiplied to which number, which term to get x cube as a product? It is x. So x square into x is x cube, minus x into x, that is minus x square, and 1 into x is x. So change the sign, minus plus minus cancel. Minus 4x square and 1x square, plus 1x square will be minus 3x square, and plus 4x minus 1x will be plus 3x. Okay, plus 5. Now x square will be multiplied to dash to get minus 3x square, and it is none other than minus 3. X square into minus 3. So minus 3x square, minus x into minus 3, it's a plus 3x, 1 into minus 3, that is minus 3, change the sign, plus, minus, plus, cancel, 5 plus 3 is 8. So this is the remainder. Okay, so you can write quotient q of x is equal to x square plus x minus 3, and r of x is equal to 8. Too much noise. Okay, so this is how we can divide the polynomial.